Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Halo Book Reviews. I don't have much to say. Today I'm talking about Halo Contact Harvest by Joseph Staton, who was a writer on Halos 1, 2, and 3. The basic synopsis is this is the first contact that the humans have with the Covenant. It does a lot of things really well in terms of that. We follow Avery Johnson. Johnson is an awesome character in the video games, one of the coolest characters in all of video games. We get to follow him. We get an origin story for Jenkins, the guy who dies in the first Halo game. And if you read the novelization to the game, as a very disturbing ending to his arc. We learn in this book how the prophets of regret, mercy, and truth came to be. We learn stuff about Tartarus, the guy from the second game and third game. We get to learn about him. So there's a lot of cool stuff that sets up a lot of what we already know in the games. Do I think this is a phenomenally written book? I'm going to be honest and say, no, it's pretty basic. I just want to say I've written, or not written, I've read books that have been written much better. Also, as for the action for me personally, it did not grab me, did not keep me engaged, so I found myself kind of just like breezing over and making sure I wasn't missing anything important and skipping ahead, because I mean, I guess Halo is an action series, but it just, that wasn't for me. Whereas in the Fall of Reach book, there was stuff in there that I thought the way it was written, even though I think it's written by the same person, no, it was Eric Nyland, but I just felt the action scenes were written a way to where I actually could be engaged with it, but I didn't feel that way about this book. But as an origin story also for why the Covenant is so relentless and why they hate humans, because the Covenant in of itself is a collection of alien people, right? That's why the new show that's come out, which I will have my full thoughts on when all the episodes are said and done, because I don't want to do episode by episode. I want to get my full thoughts and hold things out. But the whole idea of having a human in the Covenant kind of ruins a lot of things for me, and I don't know why they decided to do it that, because, you know, in the games, in the extended lore, it's like, these guys are relentless, the humanity is fighting a losing battle, and the only thing keeping the darkness at bay, really, is, you know, the Spartans and stuff. But why won't they ever let humans into the ranks? Well, if you read this story, you find out exactly why they won't let humans into their ranks, why solely the only options with humans is to kill them. And you learn about that here. The writing for Johnson was very good. I mean, Joseph Staton helped write for the actual video game. So it makes sense why Johnson is so in line with this character that we see in the video game. We also get more of a backstory for him as well, which I thought was really nice. There's a couple AI characters. They have an interesting little story going on. I don't really want to spoil that. That was one of the more interesting parts. I have to say, Sergeant Johnson is probably the most boring part of this book. The most interesting parts of this book are the parts where we get to actually see the bits and pieces of, you know, the Covenant structure, how the politics works and all that. I mean, we have Broken Circle, but this dives into it, I think, first, before that book came out. But there's a lot of interesting stuff in here, dealing with the Covenant, and I really enjoyed seeing that. We also see all the insurrectionists in this book have, you know, they've been the issue this whole time up until the Covenant showed up. And even with the way things go down, with it becoming a reluctant hello to an all-out bloody battle on here, I thought was done really well. And overall, you know, I thought the book was good. It's not great. It's not bad. If you want to know more about Halo, I think this is one of the books you need to read. I think, because Halo itself is a pretty extensive, expanded universe by this point, but I think if you want to get into Halo, I think if not just the games themselves, The Fall of Reach by Eric Nyland and this book, Contact Harvest, are an absolute must, I think, for trying to get into the series. Probably The Fall of Reach more, because it's more directly relevant to the first game, and as you know, the title character Master Chief, whereas this book does not have him at all, really. So, but I do think if you're a fan in it, if you're not, I think this might help you get into the series. However, there is one really weird part thing near the end, little slight spoiler, wasn't my cup of tea. I mean, Johnson bones down, like he has. Yes, the as the Sims call it, the woohoos with a female, and it's very descriptive, and I felt kind of dirty reading it. I was like, you're having a private moment. I shouldn't be here right now. I was gonna back away. Like, that's kind of how I felt. It felt like what 30-year-olds would read when they pick up 50 Shades of Grey. Maybe I'm being a little too harsh, but it's just like unnecessarily descriptive on some things that I just felt like I shouldn't be here, right? Like, I was watching two people be intimate and I shouldn't have been a part of that. And so that's just how I felt. Maybe you guys don't care or wouldn't care if you saw it, but those are overall my thoughts. I didn't really write any notes for this book. But I definitely thought it was really interesting, to say the least. And these are going to be kind of sparse, my Halo reviews, because of course, Star Wars is my number one at the moment. That's where I'm getting most of my views. But I wanted to take a small break from Star Wars to read a couple other things, so this is one of them. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video, whether that be to stop the Reclaimers or to explore more of the Star Wars Expanded Universe. I hope you will be there to join me. I am 343 Guilty Spark, and this is my demand. Anyway, sorry. Till next time, Reclaimers. Have a good one.